If horse racing is the sport of kings, then roller derby is the sport of queens. These women are strong, bold, beautiful, determined, and highly tattooed. I had to see them in action. Thankfully, the Kalamazoo Derby darlings were not as scary in person as I thought they would be. I was immediately invited to a practice where I could learn how to become a rock'em sock'em derby girl. Hold on, that's a little more than I had in mind. I was thinking that the spectator's point of view would be more my speed, especially after I found out they call the new girls fresh meat. Then I thought, what the heck? After all, it had only been 30 years since I had last put on skates. What could possibly go wrong? I started research on hip replacement therapy, just in case, and began to psych myself up for the big day. Watching the very flexible Lady Hawk, I learned the importance of stretching before a bout. I quickly realized that throwing my skates over my head was not going to happen. My mentor, Battle Axe, hooked me up with the proper equipment and rental skates. Battle Axe immediately let me in on a trade secret. The proper derby stance is called tits over toes. Learning to fall and stop correctly is imperative in derby action. So I began my drills learning to fall and pop back up. A popular fall tactic is the rock and roll. Allow me to demonstrate. The baseball slide carries a higher degree of difficulty, and Battle Axe spent extra time with me, recounting the pain of the collision of skate and buttocks. Derby is a hard-hitting sport, and it was time for me to show Battle Axe what I was made of.
She's too solid. I mean,
before I could hit the floor, I needed to add elements together. Wait, let me try that again. Tits over toes, pick up speed, rock and roll. Happily, the derby darlings were easier on me than they are with each other. It only took me 3 days until I could walk again.